Harcourts TV.
Welcome everyone to the very first episode of Harcourts TV. Here's a quick look at what you can expect. We've jam-packed our first episode with some pretty awesome material, just for you guys. And we've even thrown in a surprise interview too, because that's how we roll at Harcourts. Video is the way of the future, so it's only fitting that Harcourts leads the way once again. We hope you enjoy the experience, as Harcourts TV is all about you, the viewer. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. First up is Anton with his operational update, followed by Christelle's marketing tidbits. Enjoy.
Hi team, just a quick update from the operational desk. Our apps, obviously one of the important things, our E1 and eCampaign, our apps link back to our H1 system. Please start using those apps. That will make your life so much easier, especially managing your tasks, managing your contacts. Those apps will change your life. Then the other thing, data integrity, very important on H1. We talk about your H1 profile, we talk about the office's profile, general data being entered into the H1 system, your listings, your contacts, those type of things. So remember, Better in Blue is coming, very important to have that data correct and ensure that your data integrity in H1 is correct, but not only in H1, HTRAC also, please. So those transactions that gets captured by the office, the buyers, the sellers details, the contract details, all those things, talk to us. And please, if we're gonna start with the customer relationship management system, you'll see that we're gonna use some of that information in our customer relationship management. The better the data, the better our customer relationship management is gonna be. Then client login. Client login we've been using it for the last 2 years, but this is a game changer for you. If you don't know yet how client login works, make an effort in getting to know how client login works. Make it part of your presentation. I promise you it's a game changer. It is something that nobody else got. So get to know client login, start using it, and I can assure you that within the next year, we're going to implement a few other things. If you can already manage client login, if you can already make sure that you know how client login works, then the new technology and the new functionality that we're going to create is going to assist you even further. Hope you enjoy this update. Speak to you soon. If there's anything that you guys would like to know, please let us know at our help desk, or you know you can email me directly. We will sort it out. Thanks, guys.
Guess where I am? You're not sure, hey? I'm at Port Alfred. Richard Gray, myself, and Joe Clifford are here to personally congratulate the team from Harcourts Port Alfred on taking the title of the Year We Are Brand Spanking Blue competition. So what I'd like to do today is take you on a tour of their premises so that you can see for yourself that it personifies the new brand and values completely. Congratulations, Ellen and the team. Your hard work and vision has truly paid off. And you know what else? I just love you guys. I'm so proud of you, and you're incredibly deserving of this prize. So I hope the rest of you enjoy the video, and I'll see you next time.
Fireball.
Well, maybe you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. My mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never liked to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know. I'm better sleeping on my own, cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on, something you should go and love yourself. The only problem was with you and not them. And every time you told me my opinion was wrong, they tried to make me forget where I came from. And I didn't wanna write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby I'll be moving on. And I think it should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, she likes everyone.
Please join me in welcoming our very first guest, who also happens to be Harcourts SA CEO, Mr. Richard Gray.
Thanks, Tabani. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us. Richard, please tell me, why do you think it's important for us to have Harcourts TV?
You know, Tabani, up till now, we've always been a company that has focused very much on email communication. So for many years now, we've sent out emails and we've hoped people would read them. But you know, emails are not well read, and that was a pretty cold and unengaging, doesn't really reflect who we are. And we really felt that using the medium of something like TV would bring home our message and our communication in a much more entertaining and personal way than just sending out an email. So we really felt this was going to be the way to do it. You know, YouTube, for example, is now the second biggest search engine when you look on the internet, only to Google. So you really want to have a medium that people are looking at and searching, and this was just going to be the perfect way to do it.
Richard, the year is quickly coming to an end. What have been your highlights for 2016?
Well, Tabani, there have been many highlights, I think, for us, but the one thing that really stands out is our rebrand. Our rebrand was something that we sat and thought about, and we were a little bit nervous about what we were getting ourselves into. A lot of moving parts and pretty complex. But if you look at the results that have been achieved, I think it's simply amazing. A brand new brand out there in all those different locations, looking incredible, fresh, new. The big thing for me was that it wasn't just one or two people who'd done it either. It was very much a team effort. If you look at every office, everybody involved in Harcourts had to pull together to do it, and we definitely pulled it off. So yeah, the rebrand for me was definitely the number one thing this year.
Well, it definitely sounds fantastic. What do you think we can look forward to in 2017?
Well, 2017 is going to be a really interesting year for us, Tabani. I think, you know, if we have a look at a market that is under a bit of pressure now and is probably going to get worse, I think that the real estate industry is likely to contract quite a lot next year. So we're going to find that people leave the industry, which is typically what happens when the market does slow down. We end up with a slightly smaller industry. Obviously, Harcourt's aspirations are to continue growing. So we would like to see ourselves growing as everybody else is contracting. So we've got some great programs in place in terms of recruiting agents, getting some new key offices in place, and also growing the commercial side of our business, which will once again allow us to grow while the rest of the market contracts, and that really excites me.
Thank you so much, Richard. It all sounds very exciting. Next up is a marketing segment brought to you by Mersane Media to help you take your online marketing to the next level.
It's one thing developing strategic content, and it's something completely different perpetually distributing corporate branded ads. If all you're ever doing is social speaking as opposed to social listening, your community is going to stop listening to you. Don't try and predict what they want to hear, but rather engage and react to their content. Be involved in the conversation. I'm going to tell you one thing now that's going to fundamentally shift the way you think about your content. Tell your story. Yours. Document your path. Don't try and create an impression or perception of what your business is, but rather document your growth, document your troubles, document your meetings. tell your story in a way that only you can.
Here we go.
Let's catch the old breath there for a second. Wipe the teardrops. Many may say it's even a sweat drop. I recently participated in the 70.3 Ironman here in Durban. Enrolled for it in December. 6 months later, it was D-Day. And while you're spending so much time training for cycling on roads, running fortunately on beautiful beaches like this for endless kilometers, and even so brave as to swim in the ocean, you've got lots of time to think. And I think I've learned a few lessons out of all of this activity. And I want to share one of them this morning. It's the rule of the program will dictate success. And when you set that goal of the distances, you also break it down into activity, intensity, and frequency of activity that you have to mix all of these different disciplines in. And the big thing that I found is it doesn't matter if you get up in the morning and it's cold and windy maybe, or it might be a pretty hot and muggy day. If you feel like it or if you don't, the program will lead to success. If you have the discipline to follow it, you're guaranteed an outcome that you actually want. So I found in business the same sort of lesson exists. We set ourselves some goals in terms of income, financial security, etc. We do a business plan, a program on how to achieve it. And every time we compromise on the program, we actually move our goal further ahead. Maybe we land up only with a version of what we wanted to achieve and not exactly what we wanted. So I just want to encourage you this morning that when you set the program, be diligent to perform what the program dictates. Well, I'm sort of halfway through the early morning run. I'm sure we'll chat soon. Thank you for listening.
Some brilliant insights and motivation there from my general manager. Thanks, Jan.
The key to success is education. Let's take some time to look at upcoming training events for Harcourts South Africa. If you liked any of the upcoming training events, please go to your H1 and book your seat today.
It's time to get up to speed with the latest happenings in the Harcourts universe. Straight from the CEO, here's Team Talk with Richard Gray.
Hi everyone and welcome to Team Talk. Well, it's been another good month. So in September, we had our top five offices being Platinum, Select, Rhino, Port Alfred, first time in the top five, and House of Real Estate. So congratulations to all of you. A really solid month for Harcourts, and we were certainly better than we were last year. So it's a good growth month for us as a company as well. Some really good agent performance as well. Top agent was Jason Hutton. Congrats, Jason. And then after that, Mark White, Minky Matthews, Michael Pashley, and Maureen Nell. Well done to all of you. Really good achievement. And we had some of our officers who had their best months ever, led by Harcourts Aurora from up in Joburg, Heritage also in Joburg, Platinum, Port Alfred, and Select. Well done to all of you. September is normally a quietish month, so you did extremely well in coming out on top. We're really excited about next year because one of our big things next year is our conference, and we know where it's going to be. We're having it in Swaziland. We haven't been for about 5 or 6 years. Those of you who have attended conference in Swaziland will know that it's always one of the best conferences. It's a magnificent venue and it's not that difficult to get there. So I'm asking all of you to start putting some money away and make sure that you can be at Swaziland for our conference in 2017, and look out for the information coming out on that. We don't often talk about rentals on the show, but we have some really exciting news in terms of our rentals. We've been waiting for a while for this, but we finally have daily and weekly rentals, which allows you on H1 to manage your holiday rentals a lot more effectively. And that I know has been something that a number of you have been wanting, and you've now got it. So normally around October, as you have a choice, you either now relax for the last 3 months of the year, recharge your batteries and get ready for next year, or you really push hard for the next 3 months. And I'm telling you now, you actually don't have a choice. You have to push hard. Because if you think about it, the deals that you're writing now will be the deals that register at the beginning of next year. So what you're working on now is your income in January and February, which you definitely need after Christmas. So make sure that you make these 3 months huge. It'll get you a great start for next year. Till next time, cheers.
And now for another special guest, a man that needs no introduction to Harcourts South Africa, Mike Green, Managing Director of Harcourts International. Welcome, Mike, to our first episode. What do you think about the concept of Harcourts TV?
I think it's a really exciting initiative. I think we all know the impact that video is having in terms of real estate and how we market property. If you're on social media and to Facebook, you see more and more videos appearing. It's a wonderful tool for communication, for sharing ideas. So to do it internally, to stream video messages to our team, I think it's just fantastic. It's a really exciting initiative.
Thank you, Mike, for taking the time to chat to us and share your thoughts. What message do you have for Harcourts South Africa?
Hey, just finally, a message for our team in South Africa. And I mean, there's so many things that I could sit here and tell you, and you need to know that outside of South Africa, the wider Harcourts Group is hugely aware of South Africa and the wonderful things that you've done over the last 6, 7, 8, 9 years. Enormously proud of what we're achieving in South Africa. There is obviously a really strong connection through New Zealand, Australia with South Africa. You know, we very much feel like you're a significant and strong and important part of our family. So to see the levels of success, to see what Richard's done in terms of the leadership in South Africa, our board members and our top businesses and how well they've grown and developed over the last few years, but just across the board to see the wonderful results that our team in South Africa are achieving through simply focusing on the basics, you know, being passionate about the brand, delivering the Harcourts promise, just doing the things that we all know we should do, but perhaps, you know, find hard to do at times. And to be able to do that the way you are, to achieve the results you are, I just need to, I guess the one message that I want to share with you is that Irene and I are just incredibly proud of our team in South Africa, our family in South Africa. And it gives us just, you know, so much satisfaction, I guess, and pride when we visit with you and when we see, obviously, what you're doing. So thank you for all that you do for the brand. You are a wonderful, wonderful team of people and a very special and important part of the Harcourts organisation. So I look forward to seeing you all in May at the conference.
Thank you, Mike. It was great having you as part of our very first episode of Harcourts TV. We really hope you enjoyed the first episode of Harcourts TV. Be sure to leave a comment below and like our page. Till next time, have a great Harcourts day.